Alan to come up and share a message for the Gideons. And we appreciate you coming. We appreciate the work that the Gideons are doing. He'll deliver a message, and then afterward we'll do the Lord's Supper. And then after we're done with all that, then I'll have him stand up here, and if you got an offering that you want to give to the Gideons, you can come up here and do that then.
That sounds good.
And you let me know when you want me to play the video.
You don't know anything about drugs. They say it's a bad thing these days. It takes people's life. It controls them. But I want you to know that it doesn't have any power compared to the power of our God. This can be illustrated by a fellow named Joplin Epperson. Joplin took drugs all the way through high school. He said he would take drugs in the morning before he got to school. He'd take drugs during the school day. Finally, when he was a senior, he overdosed one day. When he woke up, he was astonished because there was teachers and a principal and everything around him. He wondered just how in the world he let his life get so far out of control. But it didn't stop him. He got out of school, he went to work, kept taking drugs. He started selling drugs. When he was 20 years old, he got feeling so bad about his situation and his life, what he was doing. And he thought, I'll just take my life. I'm not doing anybody any good. And he got to thinking about it and thought, well, I never have believed in God or heaven or hell or anything. But what if I'm wrong? So he went and found the little New Testament they gave him when he graduated. And he read in there. He read where it said, Jesus promised whoever is ask, receive, whoever seeks, finds. Whoever knocks, the door be open. And he thought, whoever, that applies to me. If I can prove that promise is wrong, then I'll know I'm right, there is no God. So he decided that he would take the next 30 days, and he would try to live right, he'd go to church. And if that promise wasn't answered, he figured that he's right, there wasn't any God, there wasn't any need for him to not commit suicide. First 2 weeks he went to the local church where people knew him, and they ignored him because they knew what kind of guy he was or had been. And the third Sunday he decided he'd go down the road a ways to a large church where people didn't know him. And at the end of the service, a little lady, he said she was 73 years old, her name was Nadine Ledbetter, and she said, that's the first time you've been here, isn't it? He said, yes ma'am, it is. She said, would you come back? And he said with tears in his eyes, he said, he could just feel that love and concern. He said, yes, ma'am, I will. And the next Sunday he came back, sat on the front row. He said he listened to the pastor. And he was really impressed with the guy. He said he didn't know what he had, but he sure wanted it. So when the service was over, he went up. And he said, prayed to the Lord, said, God, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. He said that over and over again. And he got saved. And he'd never been the same since. And now he tells people that he spent the last 14 years that there's a God in heaven. His son's Jesus, and he loves you. And it can change your life. He often said, if he can change my life, he can change anybody's life. This testimony is an example of how God's word and the church, work of the church, can change a life. And it shows how powerful our Lord is. The word placed by Gideon and the church work together. Gideon's work with the church. That's our thing. We are all active church members. But in this case, it saved a soul and created a powerful witness for the Lord. And I learned Thursday night that Joplin had become a pastor. I didn't know that until then. I knew this story about Joplin. I years ago, but he's become a pastor again. Gideon's International is a non-denominational organization of Christian business and professional men. And we're active in our local churches, and our sole purpose is to bring men and women, boys and girls, to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. We do that through distributing scriptures and personal witnessing. And it takes both. We hear stories where the scripture did the job, or the scripture and some other Christian witnessed something that did the job. And we hear stories where Gideon gave somebody the scripture and led them through it, and they were saved. By God's grace, last year, we placed 82,539,518 scriptures, plus 5,040,400 life books. That's a little book that we give high school kids to give to other high school kids. You might notice that I gave you an exact number of those scriptures. That's because we believe that God has a use for each and every one of them. So we think each and every one of them counts. And so I don't just round it off and say we gave a little over 82 million. I want you to know how many it was exactly.
Amen.
We believe in the promise of Isaiah 55:11, that God's word does not return void, as we, men, women, boys, and girls, come to Christ through reading scripture that was placed by Gideon. If you are a Christian business or professional man, you would like additional information about becoming a witness for the Lord and spread his word as a Gideon, let me know after the service. I'll be glad to talk to you. If you are unable to become a Gideon, but you're interested in the work of the Gideons, we have a program called Friend of the Gideons that I would like to tell you about. So if you just say something to me about it, I'll tell you all about it, give you a brochure on it. Gideon's International, of course, is best known for placement of Bibles in hotels. But we also place them in schools and colleges and military, in jails and fire and police departments and hospitals and medical facilities and doctor's offices, nursing homes, crisis centers, in 201 countries and 107 languages. Didn't know there was 107 languages, did you, Brother Parker? That's a lot of languages, isn't it?
Yeah.
In recent years, many public schools have stopped letting people come in and give things like Bibles. So, and that's happened to us in Meade County. They were threatened with a lawsuit, so they stopped us from coming. So we had to look for other ways to give scriptures out. And we found them. And so I want to let you tell you about what the Meade County Gideons have done in the past couple of years. And just for the past year, I'll give you kind of a little rundown. One of the big events is Halloween time. You wouldn't think so, but we have opportunities then to give out scriptures. We had three different places this past year. One was at Buck Grove, one was at First Baptist, and one was out at Meade Old Park at Frankie's Fright Fest, I think they call it. We gave out 450 at Frankie's Fright Fest at Meade Old Park, and we gave out 450 at First Baptist Trunk or Treat, and we gave out 220 at Buck Grove Fall Festival. Then at Christmas, we offered scriptures to the folks that came to the angel trees to pick up their Christmas goodies for their kiddos. And 310 scriptures were given out there. And then there was an older group this past year that were assisted by, I think it was still kind of the angel tree, but it was for older people. And they received 35 scriptures. You might have seen us at the Meade County Fair. Seems like each year we do a little better there. This past year we gave out 975 scriptures. And more recently, down by the river, they had Tucker's Day just a couple weeks ago. 220 scriptures were given out there, even though they were rained out early. If it hadn't rained, we might have got 400 there. I don't know. But I thought you needed to have an idea of what our local Gideons are doing to spread the word, besides just trying to gather money to buy scriptures. That's 2,642 copies of God's word that were given out in the past year in Meade County. I don't give out that would do good, but I know that that's 2,642 that wasn't there a year ago. They are now in somebody's hand where they can use them. I always say that they won't save anybody's soul when they're in that box. You got to get them out in somebody's hand. So we also keep the local motels and bed and breakfasts furnished with Bibles, and the doctor's offices and medical facilities and nursing and assisted living homes. And we take some Bibles down to Meade County Jail. They have other sources for some of their Bibles, but we also give them some. We are determined to make sure the scriptures are available to our local citizens. And of course, we especially want to always make sure we catch those youngsters, because that's when they're seeking answers. I want to tell you about a Gideon and his wife on a vacation in Nebraska. They had prayed before they left that each day that they might have an opportunity to witness to somebody and give them a scripture. And they received a letter a few months after they got home from their vacation. And it went like this. It said, "Folks, I had a right to thank you. I'm the waitress that you talked with and gave a personal orders testament to in Lincoln, Nebraska. I told you about my sister being a Christian. Well, you started me, and my sister and her church prayed for me, and now I've accepted Christ. And I can say that I'm a Christian. I have the testament that you gave me, and I always will. I cannot thank you enough. Keep doing what you're doing." Mark McNett from California tells this story. He said recently he sat behind a lady in the church. He noticed her Bible, and he could tell it was very precious to her. He could see where she'd made handmade tabs in it, and when she opened it up, he could see a lot of notes in it. So in a few minutes, she laid down beside her where he could get a good view of it, and he recognized it. He thought it was. He said it was a well-worn Gideon hotel Bible. He said after the church service was over, he introduced himself and asked, her name was Denise, I believe, he asked her about her Bible. And she told him, said, "I've had it for many years." She said, "At one time in my life, I was homeless, and I prayed to God that I could have my own Bible. Shortly thereafter, she found this Bible as she dug through a dumpster. She saw how God had answered her prayer. She said she had thought about getting a new Bible, but she decided that God wanted her to have that one." You know, not all Bibles and New Testaments end up with the person that we give them to. And you hear about people getting a Bible or a testament and throwing it in a drawer or whatever, or throwing it in a dumpster. But a lot of times we find out that God guides that testament, that scripture, to someone where it does a lot of good. What someone discarded as yesterday's garbage, Denise now treasures forever. Revelation 21:5 says, "Behold, I make all things new." Ready for that video. Here's a short video that shows Gideon's love in action. And you'll notice when he plays it that they mention that there are about 2 million scriptures have been given. Well, that's a little bit out of date. That figure is now 2,289,665,301. So it's about 4 or 5 years old.